Step 3, setting dependencies. We've already gone through step 1, which is all about creating the work breakdown structure, which represents everything you need to do to accomplish the project. And once you figure out what you need to do, then step 2 is all about figuring out how long each one of those things take. And then step 3 is really then sequencing those together or determining when they will occur and setting up your network or dependencies or links between the tasks. There are different types of scenarios that you'll go through. There are sequential scenario where task 1 happens before task 2 and task 2 happens before task 3 and everything happens in sequence. You may have concurrent where task 1 and task 2 can happen at the same time before task 3 can start. Or you may have some overlap scenarios where task 1 halfway through completion you can start task 2, or halfway through task 2 you can start task 3, or maybe at the end of task 1 you have to wait 5 days before you start task 2, and you can use the lag field and put in positive or negative values to accomplish that. The terminology that project uses is finish to start, or FS, so when you finish task 1, start task 2, and that's sequential. You can force things to start at the same time in a start-to-start relationship, or finish to finish. You can even use this rarely used one called start to finish to create a backwards type of link. In setting dependencies, there's many different tools you can use. There's the linking tool, there's the split screen, there's the predecessor column, and I'll show you all these different techniques. And once you get your network put together, you then have the opportunity to review your critical path. So in the first scenario, sequence or sequential activities, in this particular case we're saying task 1 is a predecessor to task 2. And task 2 is a successor of task 1. And in this case, task 3 has a predecessor of task 2, and so on. And if you look at task 1 does not have a predecessor, and in fact will be driven by the project start date. And task 3 does not have a successor, so in fact it's the last thing in this project schedule. And that's sequential, and most of that can be accomplished with a finish to start type of link. Here we have some concurrent tasks, where task 1 and 2 can happen at the same time. Notice there's actually no link between them. And so in this case, they'll be driven by the project start date. They'll both have to be done before task 3 can start. So obviously, the longer one of those tasks will be on the critical path. And we'll talk more about the critical path in the next section. And then task 4 has a predecessor of task 3. And task 5 has a predecessor of task 3. So task 3 has two successors, task 4 and 5. And because they have task 4 and 5 have the same predecessor, that means that they will occur at the same time, or by default be concurrent. So that's more of a concurrent scenario. We can also have partially dependent tasks or overlapping tasks. And in this case, what we're saying in task 1, halfway through start task 2. So we have a dependency, a finish to start relationship between task 1 and 2. But in the lag field, we can type in minus 50% or minus 5 days or half the duration. If you put positive values, then you'll create a gap between the tasks. So wait 5 days before you start task 3, for example. So task 2 to task 3, we have a finish to start relationship with a minus 5 days. And what that means is when you finish task 2, you can start task 3, but pull it back 5 days. So you get this overlapping scenario in Microsoft Project in your network. So let's go take a look.